Hello, my dear students. I hope you people are fine. So, in this video, let us continue with our previous chapter, that is the typical configuration of computer system. In previous video, we have completed with certain terminologies, computer, users, hardware, software, as the review block of the diagram, block diagram of computer we have completed. In this video, let us move on to the further topics. That is the motherboard. This motherboard, it is very important part of the any computer system because the entire computer is built around a motherboard. So we can call this the motherboard as the main circuit board which has been placed in a computer. This is to be the main circuit board. All your input devices, output devices, everything they are being connected to on this motherboard. Without this motherboard, we can't have any kind of computational work done in the computer system. Okay, let us see the definition of the motherboard. The motherboard is being called as the large printed circuit board. It is being called as a large printed circuit board because it has many chips, it has the ports, controller, and other electronic components are being mounted on it. Mounted in the sense placed on it. You can see there are so many different kinds of chips, there are different kinds of capacitors, you know, different kinds of memory slots, PCI slots, AGP slots, different kinds of memory chips, okay, different kinds of ports, controller you can see on this. Hence you can call this motherboard as a large printed circuit board. Then why we need to use this motherboard? Mainly, this motherboard makes every component inside the computer system to communicate with each other through the motherboard. Either directly by plugging onto the motherboard or by communicating through one of the ports of the motherboard. For an example, we know that as the input has been provided by the user through the input devices. Like for example, through the input devices like mouse or keyboard, you will accept the data, you will provide the data to the computer and computer will accept the data through the input unit. Now, before it is being processed, that input data has to first go to the memory, that is a primary memory, that is random access memory. We have studied this concept in the review block diagram of computer. Your input will be first accepted by the primary memory. Primary memory will then forward that data for the processing purpose to the central processing unit. Therein, first unit is the control unit. Control unit will divide the entire instruction into series of instruction, then provide to the ALU for the processing. ALU, then it will process your data, again can forward that data to the RAM. Before the final result is displayed onto the output unit, your data has been, a copy of that has been placed into the memory, that is the random access memory. And then the primary memory will hand over the data to the output unit for the users in order to display onto your monitor. Now, isn't it the different kinds of, you know, units are communicating with each other? Input unit is communicating with memory unit. Memory, it is communicating with the CPU. CPU again turn with memory. Memory again, it is all communicating with the output unit. Now, this is the motherboard it is responsible for making sure that all the different kinds of, you know, units communicate with each other. Okay, that is why this motherboard actually provides the platform for all the different kinds of components and the peripheral devices. Peripheral devices like, you know, external devices in order to communicate with each other. External devices, you know, like speakers. Speakers are connected to your computer system. So whenever you play any song, audio or video, the sound signals generated from your computer system has to reach to the users through the speakers. A speaker is an output device, isn't it? Okay, your monitor is an output device. It is displaying you the data, isn't it? So the peripheral, it is making all the components available onto the motherboard as well as the peripheral components to communicate with each other. It's providing a platform. Hence, this motherboard is called as the main circuit board, which is responsible for making sure that there is a data transfer between all the components present on it. Now let us see what are the different electronic components that are being mounted on the motherboard. Like for example, processor. This is a processor. memory chips like RAM slots, random access memory slots we are having here. Then we are having interfaces, ports, expansion cards, okay, PCI slots we are having, that is a peripheral component interconnect, ISA, industry structured architecture, AGP, accelerated ports, graphics ports, we are having different kinds of electronic components are mounted in it. Apart where the RAM, hard drive, disk drive, optical drives, they are all plugged into the interfaces. That means there are different kinds of hard drives, random access memory, these are the slots, RAM slots, they're all being mounted on this motherboard. Therefore we can call the motherboard as the hub, which allows you to connect all the different components of a computer with each other. So hub is, we have seen this hub as a terminology in the star topology, where the hub is nothing but the central processor, that's a central unit. Where without the hub, there is no computer systems can communicate with each other over the network. Similarly, without this motherboard, no different electronic components can communicate with each other. Hence, we can also refer this motherboard to be as the hub. I hope you people are understanding. Now, moving on to the, what are the characteristics of motherboard? So, based upon the three factors, based upon these three different kinds of factors or the characteristics our motherboard are being designed. The first one is the form factor, the second is the chipset, and the third is the processor socket. Coming on to the first one, what is this form factor actually referred to? The motherboard's geometry, dimensions, arrangement, and electrical requirements. Now, based upon this, different motherboards are being there for the different devices. For example, the shape and the dimensions are different for the motherboard for the desktop computers. Different dimension shapes are required for the laptop computers, for the motherboards for the laptop computers. Different motherboards we need for the mobile devices. So this is the form factor is mainly deciding about the what should be the motherboard's geometry, what the dimension should be there, what kind of arrangement should be there, and what are the different electrical requirements are there that has to be placed on the motherboard for the different devices like, desktop computers, your laptop computers or the mobile devices or any other tablets or whatever, notebook, whatever different kinds of motherboard. Based upon these factors, we have a different types of motherboards present. Actually, this form factor determines the size, dimensions of that motherboard. Okay, the latest, all the desktop computers, the latest motherboard what we are using is the Advanced Technology Extended motherboard. That is the ATX motherboard, which is the most common design for the motherboard, which have been nowadays we are using for the desktop computer systems. Okay, moving on to the next characteristics, that is a chipset. Okay, the main functionality of this chipset is to provide the coordination between the different components for the data transfer between the various components of computer. We know that this motherboard is providing a platform. It is a main circuit board which is helping the different electronic components to be placed on it. Then who is actually taking the responsibility for the data transfer is the chipset. I'll show you this one of the image of chipset. Now this is a chipset. Okay, chipset is a kind of a set of electronic components. It is integrated. It's an integrated circuit that manages the data flow between the processor, memory, and the peripheral. It is usually found on the motherboard of the computer. This chipset is mainly providing the coordination between all the different kinds of electronic components, and it is helping to have the data transfer between them. We know that many components are being mounted on the motherboard. Okay, for example, processor, RAM slots, I said about certain ISA, AGP slots, okay, PCI slots. These slots we will discuss in the next video with in detail what those slots are. So this is a chipset is a responsibility in order to provide the data transfer between them. So it is very important to choose the motherboard that has a very recent chipset. So in order to maximize the computer's upgradability, if the recent chipset if you are using, you are getting the recent developments of the computer, the latest form of computers you will be able to have. So this is one of the second characteristics of the motherboard. Moving on to the third characteristic, that is the processor socket. So on different types of motherboard, there may be a different types of processor socket. Processor socket, I'll show you. This is how the processor socket or the CPU socket. So different motherboards we are having, like, you know, baby AT motherboard, XT motherboard, ATX motherboard. Different types of motherboards are having the different, you know, processor sockets we are having. One of these socket might be a rectangular connector. Now this is a kind, you know, rectangular connector where the processor can be placed or mounted vertically. Or maybe there may be some other different kind of processor socket, which is a square shaped connector with some small connectors into which the processor directly it is being inserted. Now this is the processor socket where a microprocessor is being placed. Understood? So microprocessor placed in within this CPU socket. Based upon, there are different kinds of processor socket we'll get. One is rectangular shaped, one is the square shaped, one is a pin grid PGA socket, processor sockets. We are having different kinds of motherboards are having different kinds of CPU sockets where it is helping you to place the processor into it. Processor is nothing but this is the processor. So this processor, Intel processor, is been placed into this CPU socket, which might be a different kind of, you know, shapes it might be. So based upon these three characters, we have a different kinds of motherboard available in the market. One is the form factor, which is actually dealing with the geometry, dimensions, and what are the requirements, electrical requirements that are needed for the motherboard, depending upon the devices you are using. Next, we are having the chipset. We have to use the recent chipset so that there should be a faster data transfer rate. If there is a faster data transfer rate between the your input to the memory, memory to for the processing, processing again back to memory to the output, means the more the faster data transfer rate, the more the processing speed will be more of your computer, and your computer performance will be very high. Your computer will be very fast. Okay, so that is the reason why you have to use the recent chipset. Last is the processor socket. So there are different kinds of processor socket based upon the recent kind of, you know, whatever microprocessor you are using. It might be a rectangular, the processor socket might be rectangular or square shaped it might be. Depending upon your motherboard geometry, you have to you choose the processor socket. So these three are the three different character based upon which the motherboards are being usually designed. Now let us move on to the different types of motherboard. So we have the different types of motherboard. Almost we are having four different types of motherboard. The first is the XT motherboard, AT motherboard, baby AT motherboard, and then ATX motherboard we are having. The first is the XT motherboard. So this was the earliest motherboard. The look of this motherboard and the recent which I have shown the motherboard, it's quite different. So this was the oldest, you know, motherboard. That is XT, stand for extended technology. Okay, so these extended technology motherboard, they are having the old model motherboard, which includes the old model processor socket, that is the low insertion force socket we are using. Here you can see it is having the old, you know, model processor socket where we have to place our socket. That is what kind of we are using, LIF, low insertion force socket. Low insertion force socket means it is just having a, you know, kind of now this is a kind of a low insertion where you just need to place the processor, and it is having certain latching system. Just place the processor and just fix the latch, that's it. That is nothing but low insertion force socket. Such kinds of processor sockets are been used in the XT motherboard, and it is also using the RAM slots for the DIM. RAM slots, like DIM actually stands for dual inline memory module. RAM slots in the sense, now actually this is your RAM, that is random access memory. This is a slot. This slot are being placed here. These are being placed here. Now this random access memory, so DIM in a sense, the random access memory on the motherboard are being stored in the modules that are called as dual inline memory modules. Now these are dual inline memory modules. This is the RAM slot. So here what kind of a memory we are using is dual inline memory modules. So we are also having the single inline memory module where the data transfer rate in SIMM is very slow, but our XT motherboard was using dual inline memory module where the data transfer rate will be very fast. We know that from input unit the data goes to the RAM, RAM to the processing. So the data transfer between the your random access memory and the central unit, so the central processing unit for the processing purpose, should be very fast. Now this XT motherboard, it is using the RAM slots of dual inline memory module, which is helping you to transfer the data for the processing purpose. And this XT motherboard, it is also using certain slots like ISC slots. That is, ISA slots are, I'll show you here. Yeah, it is also XT. Don't look at this PCI slot. This is different, I'll show. These are the ISA slots, which stands for the industry standard architecture slots. These ISA slots are actually used to connect the modem, internal modems we are having. Okay, so for that, to have the internal modem, these ISA slots are being responsible. Then it is also using the 12 pin power connector, and it is having no ports. XT motherboard is using 12 pin power connector. You can see this is 12 pin power connector, and this XT motherboard, it is not having any external ports. Like external devices you cannot connect, like your USB flash drive or such things were unable. External external speakers and all, you are unable to connect to such kinds of the motherboard. So therefore this XT motherboard is one of the oldest form of the motherboard, which is consisting of low insertion force socket. Okay, it consists of RAM, but what kind of RAM? Dual inline memory modules it will consist of. It will consist of ISA, that is industry standard architecture slots it will consist of, which is used to connect for the modems, and it is consist of the 12 pin power connector, and it is not having any kind of ports. That means you can see there is no external ports attached to your motherboard. External ports in the sense, I'll show you here. These are the external ports. One more slide I'll show you for the external ports. Yeah, you can see these are all your external ports. These external ports are helping you to connect for the Ethernet, network interface card. You can see these are the speakers card. Okay, serial port, your USB in the sense for pen drive slots, what for your laptop and computer, you where you are inserting the your pen drives, no, such kinds of, you know, slots are called as the external ports. So in XT motherboard we don't have any such kinds of, you know, external ports available in this kind of motherboard. Okay, moving on to the next type of motherboard, that is the AT motherboard. AT motherboard actually stands for the advanced technology. This advanced technology motherboard has a pin grid array sockets. I said in processor or CPU socket or the processor socket we have a different kinds. So here we are having the pin grid socket. Now this is what is the pin grid array socket. This is one of the third characteristic of your motherboard. So this is what is the, here we are able to place your microprocessor. So that is a pin grid array socket it is using, that is the PGA socket. Here in your motherboard, actually here it is there. Upon your pin grid array socket, fan is being placed here for the cooling purpose. But otherwise, this AT motherboard, which is advanced technology motherboard, is using PGA socket, and it is using the SDRAM slots, that is a synchronous dynamic random access slot it is using. So here in our previous motherboard, RAM it was using, DIMM modules it was using. Similarly, synchronous dynamic random access memory is also similar to this only. This is very much similar. Okay, to the synchronous dynamic and random access, but the data transfer for the synchronous dynamic random access memory is very fast comparatively to the DIMM. And this motherboard, AT motherboard, it is using the 20 pin power connector. How I have shown the 12 pin power connector, here it is using the 20 pin power connector, and it is using the PCI slots and the ISA slots. ISA is nothing but industry standard architecture slots it is, and the PCI slots is nothing stands for the peripheral component interconnect, which are used to connect for the graphics cards, sound cards or internal modems. Sound cards if you want to speakers, if I want to play any audio or video in a computer system, whatever the sound is being generated, it is because of the sound card present onto your motherboard. And where that sound card is being present placed, you know, that sound cards has been placed onto your PCI slots. So for this AT motherboard, it is using ISA slots also. ISA is for to connect the modems. So all these kinds of modern slots are used in the AT motherboard. Example here for this AT motherboard is the Pentium 2. Okay, so this is how the PCI slot. So here sound card is being placed. So this were about the two types of motherboards we have completed, XT motherboard and the AT motherboard. In our next video, we will see about the next two different types of motherboard. Okay, so take care of yourself. Watch the video properly, solve the assignments. Thank you, students.